And now the U.S. listing of Double Dragon's Hotel 101 finally happening this year. Hotel 101 Global has entered into a definitive merger deal with the special purpose acquisition firm JVS Pack for its NASDAQ listing. The move is happening by the second half of 2024, which the two firms expect will push Hotel 101's equity value to $2.3 billion. The company of Tycoon Injab Sia II with Jollibee Foods' Tony Tan Kaktiong previously secured the ticker HBNB on the NASDAQ. Hotel 101 Global has three overseas projects, namely in Hokkaido, Madrid, and Los Angeles. Also in company development, Security Bank forming a joint venture with Mitsubishi Motors. Company executives signed today the agreement for the JV, which establishes Mitsubishi Motors Finance Philippines. The entity will provide automobile financing services to Mitsubishi customers in the Philippines. Mitsubishi gets 51% ownership, while Security Bank holds 49%. The joint venture company begins operations next year. And finally, on the earnings stream, Century Pacific sees higher growth in 2023, despite persistent inflation. The food maker reported today a 5.6 billion peso net income after tax, higher by 12% year-on-year. Revenues also climbed to 67 billion pesos, up by 8% from 2022. Century Pacific says the growth was driven by the stronger performance of its branded segment. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. leads the ceremonial energization of the long-awaited Cebu Negros Panay subgrid. The 67.9 billion peso project aims to improve the reliability of power transmission in the western and central Visayas regions. It will also dispatch excess capacities from Mindanao to meet the growing power demand in the Visayas region. Marcos urged private generators and other stakeholders of the energy sector to invest in the new subgrid to boost regional development and meet the region's long-term electricity demands.
While the CNP is a major step forward, I implore all our stakeholders in the Visayas to strategically identify suitable locations that will host new baseload generation plants, as well as renewable energy and energy storage systems. This will bolster energy sufficiency and sustainability in Negros and Panay.